better need answers.
About what?
When I get big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
You went about it the wrong way, so we can't fix that.
I'm so straight.
She mad at you, so she come fuck me, forget back. Next time you bring me up, just make sure you stay big fat.
Tell the truth.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Tryna shatter me with lies, I ain't with that.
Hey, tell the truth.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Real big facts.
Why they mad? Cause I'm on fire and they ain't lit yet.
What's that, what's that?
And it's big fat. Big fat, big racks.
Big fat, big fat.
Back in big set.
Got a big, big bag.
F in big gap.
Get back splat.
I'm on it strong.
What's that, what's that?
Muscle six pack.
Strong.
They want my spot and don't deserve it. Can't forget that. Who you hitting it? How you missed it? I was a fresh nigga in the party. Louis V down, shades by Bagari. Whole out of body gone up a card. See you and don't speak, I'm coming like I'm Cardi. I'll expose you niggas and bitches. I'm back in that molding things. You niggas is getting too big for your britches. You need some new clothes and things. Why everybody eat money bag? This the topic, nigga.
Topic.
AP on me, cost a bag. Water faucet, nigga. Never ever did some sucker shit like pay to take a nigga off a show. She a green light, she a goat. Mac on a fucking duck the hoe. Any answers?
About what?
When I got big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
You went about it the wrong way, so we can't fix that.
I'm so straight.
She mad at you, so she come fuck me, forget back. Next time you bring me up, just make sure you stay big fat.
Tell the truth.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Tryna shatter me with lies, I ain't with that.
Hey, tell the truth.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Big fat, big fat.
Real big facts.
Why they mad? Cause I'm on fire and they ain't lit yet.
What's that, what's that?
And it's big fat.
Big ones.
Here goes some more education. Here goes some more speculation.
Here goes. Hey.
I took the money, went bought me some guns. I light the bitch up like it's Vegas.
Hey.
Keyboard killer, tough on Twitter. Making posts, giving statements.
Twitter.
Niggas full of games, PlayStation. Can't kill me, I'm a Jason.
Woo.
Yeah, go Fed, Mason.
Federal.
Lock like dreads, Haitian.
Hey.
You want my place? Take it.
Take it.
Get hit with the drum, cadence. You ain't my partner, nigga. Only hang around up a solid nigga. Say they won't smoke, but when you see them, they non toxic niggas.
Ha.
Ain't no pimp, but get your hoe before I knock a nigga.
I knock a nigga.
These little hitters wanna shoot them a movie, album, drop a nigga. Draco, Draco, hit them, nigga, splat. Turn them into Play Doh, lay them flat. Drifting in the outer.
What up, what up, what up, what up, what up? What up, y'all? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Welcome back to another Atmos Love Zone show. Man, it's been a minute since I've been on here, y'all, since Sunday, talking about different things, man. Today, there's some things I've been wanting to talk about, but my schedule and work and life kind of got in the way. But let me see who's up in here rocking with me here today. What's up, Nunya? What's going on, sis? How you doing? Nice to see you. Davis Campos, what up? Rocking with the Truth, what up? Latanya Singh, what up? Anybody else want to come in and say hello? You will get that shout out. Thank y'all for coming through. So y'all, there's a couple things that I want to talk about. Things I've been wanting to talk about. As y'all know, I am a, what's up, Miss April Showers? How you doing? Thanks for coming in. As y'all know, you know, people have different opinions. What's up, Rodney Williams? What's up, bro? How you doing? People have different opinions about things, right? That's what makes the world go around, right? You have Republicans, you have Democrats, you have independents, you have conservatives, right? They all may disagree, but on some things they may say, you know what, I disagree with you. Sheree Harris, what up? I may disagree with you, but on this subject, maybe we can come together and come to some agreement, but with everything else, I'm not. What up, Dat Nurse 1980? How you doing? However, what we're going to do today, y'all, is there's some things that I've been wanting to talk about that I'm going to talk about today. You are not going to agree with everything I say. That is just the way the world is, right? You may agree with one part of what I say, but not agree with the other part. But this is just my opinion, right? That is what this is all about. So the very first thing I'm going to talk about is the R. Kelly appeal situation. Now, I listened to Jennifer Bonjean. I probably listened to it maybe three or four times so that I could make sure that I kind of know what I was talking about before I came on here. Purple, purple, what up? Man, by the way, y'all, keep in his service in your prayers. She is going through a rough time. She is extremely strong, but please keep her in y'all prayers. She is about to have heart surgery, so please keep her in y'all's prayers, okay? Now, this R. Kelly thing, okay? Listen, this is just my opinion, all right? For those of you who don't know me, I am one of the bloggers who came out against R. Kelly. who stood up for the victims of him, stood up and read the transcripts of his Chicago trial and also his New York trial. We have a playlist on my channel. If you stroll through, you'll see a playlist of everything. We actually had some of the best readers in the world come on here and actually help me read the whole doggone court transcript. We had different voices. We had a judge. We had the prosecutor. We had debate. We had everybody. Different people playing the role, brought it together for life, okay? What's up, Angela Anderson? DJ Money! What up, DJ D Money? How you doing? So, you know, that's what we did. We really put the work in to make sure that we brought that to life. So for a lot of people, I still, y'all, to this day, there are people that are watching those videos from years ago and just now, commenting on them, right? So it's kind of crazy, but people do go back through the playlist and they say they really love the fact that we go from one day to the next. Riri was one of my readers. Excellent reader, excellent actor. Thank you, Riri, for coming in today. So y'all listen, when it comes to this appeal thing, I honestly feel as though that Bongean may have found a way to get him a little bit of light. I think that the fact that she had those judges talking to the prosecutor saying, you know, there's a lot of issues here. The judges seem to pose some questions to her, you know, based on if she was challenging the jury instructions that she said no, you know, and, you know, so they were kind of confused, like, okay, you're not challenging that. So what are you challenging? Are you challenging the law? And she was just kind of giving her idea on how the law, she felt like the founders were trying to bring across the law, right? What the founding fathers or whoever, the framers, as you may call them, what they were thinking when they wrote the law, what they were trying to interpret. Sir Miguel, what up, bro? How you doing, man? DVY, what up, bro? How you doing? Indeed. So, you know, it was definitely a very interesting thing to listen to. With all of the different things that have come out on YouTube, all the different things that the people who have been investigating this case, different bloggers, you know, talking about text messages and all that kind of stuff. A lot of that stuff didn't come up, y'all. A lot of that stuff did not come up. And it was kind of confusing to a lot of people because although it was great entertainment for YouTube, in the courtroom, it didn't even come up. Now, why it didn't come up? We're not lawyers. I don't know, right? There were some things I would have been like, you know what, if they bring this up, maybe they'll go back and look at this. Nah, didn't work out that way, okay? However, you know, I definitely think that some of the judges definitely were concerned about them trying to talk about forced labor, you know, and saying, well, I don't think this is really forced labor because, you know, so I believe Bongean or somebody brought up the Rainier case and they said, well, you know, he was actually making them do things for free. And R. Kelly in this case was, although it was, you know, maybe had been done rough, he was actually paying these girls to do this stuff. So it was kind of, it was really a really touchy exchange back and forth between the judges and Miss Bongean. But in her position, you got to understand that it's her job to fight like hell to try to get R. Kelly some type of redemption, right? There were a lot of things that came out during the trial where we found out that a lot of these girls was lying their ass off on the stand. They were just straight lying, got busted lying. Testimony still went through, right? There were some that were believed to not be true, right? The Sonyas in this case. And then you flip it around, and then there was a lot of evidence that was brought out against R. Kelly that said, yes, he did do this. He did do this. Here's the proof. Here's the text. Here's the GPS coordinates. Here's the, all this kind of stuff came out, right? So it's really just a matter of technicalities when it comes to an appeal, you know? And so it's going to be very interesting to see what the judges receive from Bongean or from the prosecutors and what they feel as though is relevant enough to actually say, hey, you know what? She has a point. This law is this. This here doesn't mean this. Government, you're reaching for this. You know, that you should, y'all should have came at him on this right here because this is the way it was supposed to be. So it's going to be very interesting. Now, the only thing that R. Kelly has against him is they only had to prove two of those elements, right? Only two. And it was like 14, I believe. Two out of 14. So if I'm incorrect, somebody please correct me. Okay. I'm not a master at this here, but you know, I read it. I do retain a lot of stuff. Okay. However, you know, I don't have nothing, no ill will against R. Kelly personally. You know, I don't like the allegations that came out against him. However, I don't like nobody lying on nobody either to try to get him, you know, locked up. I don't like that kind of stuff, right? I've came out on my channel many times and said, you know, if there's lies and deceit and stuff going on that helped aid this conviction, that I felt like, you know, he needs to be given a fair shot where it was nothing but truth that came out against him. And so we'll see what happens when it comes to this appeal. We'll see what happens. Okay. Next thing. And I don't know how many of y'all follow this YouTube crazy story where it's this young lady named Sunny, who was in a, she used to be a dancer, and you know, she was in a car wreck where she lost both of her limbs, her legs. You know, it's a big, you know, back and forth right now between her and another blogger, named Shyna Speaks. If you look it up, you can see it for yourself. They're going back and forth and beefing and all that. And me, I just kind of stay in the bushes. I just been watching this thing. What's making me talk about it is the fact that, you know, I don't really get into the back and forth between the women stuff, but I'm starting to notice that this guy, Marcus, the interview or whatever, you know, he actually, for some reason or another, he has a trend of trying to go after these women that have been through traumatic experiences, and he comes in and he, you know, shows them love and has sex with them. I'm talking about amputees, people that's done went through traumatic experiences. He butters them up, buys them flowers, takes them out, has sex with them, and then dumps them. I just personally, I just think that's one of the most degrading things that a man can do, because there really are some genuine men out here. But when you are trying to portray yourself as a genuine person online, in which if you look at his channel, he's done some nice things, right? I believe he goes online and he talks to homeless people, and he, you know, gets their stories that so we can actually hear where they come from. And some of the work that he does do, I have to give him a standing ovation for. However, there's another part of that, right? When you butter up, or you take a lady who has no legs and only use of one arm, who's a young 28-year-old girl, and you and your, I think he's in his 50s or late 40s and 60 something, older guy, and you make her think, hey, you know what? I want to love you. I want to be with you. I want to show you something different. You know what I mean? Levi! What up, bro? How you doing, bro? Shout out to Levi for Kelly, man. When you go to that woman and say, hey, you know what? I'm going to show you how a real man's supposed to treat you. I'm going to really love you. You know, you have sex with this girl with no legs. You take her overseas, take her out. I don't think he took her to New Orleans, wherever he took her to. And then you come back and then you dog the girl out. Like, and that's not the only time he's done that to women who went through traumatic experiences in life. And that's what he does. And, you know, and I don't see no men really coming out talking about, yo, that's messed up. Why do you search for women that are vulnerable, probably low down on themselves, trying to understand how to recover in their lives, and you lock into that vulnerability and you come in like Romeo and you try to butter them up and sweet talk them and do interviews with them, make them think they special. You fuck them and then you fucking leave them. And you put it out. It's out here on the internet. It's not something that's hidden. I just think that's despicable. I detest stuff like that, right? That's just, it's horrible. And karma has a way of coming back on people, right? Now, this young lady, her name is Sunny, right? She's going back and forth with, you know, Shyna right now. I believe she told Shyna she hopes her dogs die. And I heard Shyna talking about her and, you know, they call her torso or some kind of crazy shit. So they going back and forth, right? I don't get into that stuff. This got nothing to do with me. My beef with this situation is the fact that there's a man out here that is searching for finding homeless, vulnerable women who have been through traumatic experiences, coming in like Captain Saver and trying to butter them up and make them think that he love them, fuck them and dump them. That's despicable. It's despicable. Right. And for that guy, like that, I'm sure there's other women that you can find that are not as vulnerable and in as bad a situation that you can charm and love and be with, as opposed to doing this to these younger. This girl's 28 years old. Think she's got two kids. Just now really trying to understand how to navigate through life. I listened to some of her videos. Yes, she is. She's a little hood, right? She's a little, you know, loud voice, you know, kind of drinks and does her thing. That's her. But nobody, no matter what their personality is or what they do, deserves for any man to come in, recognize their vulnerability, make them say, hey, yeah, I know you ain't got no legs, and I ain't no man, other man gonna love you the way you should be loved, but I'm gonna do that. And then you put it out here on YouTube and you show that you're doing something that's supposed to be special, and then you end up just straight dogging them out. I just think that's really messed up. Just my opinion. That's just my opinion. I think that's messed up. And I think there's other things you could be doing with your time other than doing things like that. If y'all want to look it up for yourselves, look it up. I guess the guy's name is Marcus, the interviewer. He tells like ATL homeless people stories or whatever. And he finds stories that are, you know, unique. And he puts these people on camera and has them speak about their traumatic life experiences, why they were homeless, what they went through. And he finds these women that, you know, are missing arms and legs and them being shot and all this kind of stuff. And he fucks them and dumps them. What kind of shit is that? Why? I don't know. Anyway, that's enough about that guy, right, in that situation. I just think it's despicable, right? Now, another situation. And I want y'all to see this now before I get to my last story. I don't know how many of y'all follow basketball. I don't know how many of y'all follow basketball, NBA, but I'm a real big basketball fan, right? So there's this story about this basketball player named Ja Morant. I don't know if y'all have ever heard of Ja Morant, but he is probably, I would say, one of the most talented basketball players to ever come into the league. This guy has been suspended multiple times, has lost over $24 to $28 million because he continues to flash and show guns on Instagram or on the internet. Now, I don't get it. You know, people say, oh, well, he's young and, you know, and he gonna make mistakes. If I lost $24 to $28 million out of my NBA career, and all I had to do was stop showing guns on the internet because I'm supposed to be a role model for kids, and I got a Nike shoe brand out there that kids are buying. So when you buy the shoe of a player, you watch how they play and you follow their story and see what they do. And you get one little influential 11, 12 or 13 year old who decides, you know what? I want to be like Ja Morant when I grow up. I need a gun. Where'd you learn that from? Ja Morant show guns all the time. I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't understand it. It's one of the dumbest, idiotic. Yes, this y'all, this just, let me show y'all this, man. I can't make this shit up. Hold on. And now, let me play this for y'all. Hold on.
The Grizzlies or even the NBA, this is an important conversation, so buckle up for it. What is your reaction to Ja Morant and that video that just resurfaced again?
I mean, I'm upset. I'm upset for the simple fact that, well, first of all, my son loves Ja Morant.
My How old is your son?
13-year-old son loves Ja Morant. Mm. Now, from the tattoos to the, I'm a little jealous because I don't have hair, but the tattoos to the dreads to the everything like that, you know, these kids mimic him. Mm-hmm. So now you see this slap on the wrist 2 months ago.
Y'all hit that like button for your bro. Hit that like button. It's free. By the way. Hit the like button.
Six things happened. Well, four of them was gunplay. Mm. I'm from North Philadelphia. My father's a two striker. My brother served three lifetimes. My uncle was a lifer. I understand, Jill. I understand all those things. I grew up in a rough neighborhood. For Ja Morant, he has a responsibility, and Joy was speaking about this. We were in the room. He has a child, so stop acting like a child. That's my thing. And you know, the incident with his mother calling twice. Mm-hmm. One was finish line. The other one, I think, was a volleyball game. Mm-hmm. So what is it, not just Ja Morant, but what is it in your household, right? Your father. What is it in your household? Who has the voice? Who can really take you to the side and say, listen, you're messing this up. Your daughter, your son, whoever, they see this. Kids see this. You have a response. Even if you don't want the responsibility, if you don't want it, stop playing. Go hide away.
Yeah.
If you want the responsibility, be responsible. Mm. That's my thing. For me, being a single father, I can't just go out there and act all crazy.
What's going on, my sister?
Responsibility.
Girl, Mel, what's up?
That's what you have. Sign the contract, stay with it, don't negotiate with the guy that's on the driver's seat, right, that don't really care.
Major, what up?
Because I have guys like that. I've been around guys like that at a very young age. Now, I was blessed to be around the Kobe's and the Alvin Williams and the Rasheed Wallace's and the Aaron McKee's, Eddie Jones, and all those guys. I stayed with them. I didn't go the other route because I saw my dad, I saw my uncle, I saw my brother. I saw guys get killed. I saw those things. So when you play with... Now, imagine if the cops would have pulled up next to them or saw them dancing and acting crazy with a gun in the car. How would you think that would end up? Now it's all this... Now we get into the race thing, but it's a gun in your hand, and you acting silly. Now, after the first time, I get it. Not the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth time.
Crazy!
I don't care what my peers say, you know what I mean? Like... you know, whatever excuse they want to give, oh, he's young, give him a listen. In baseball, you get three strikes.
Yes, Glam Libra. How you doing, Glam Libra?
You can't keep doing this because it's not about you anymore. It's about people looking, little kids looking at you and what they think they should act like. You shouldn't act like this. This is to me, doesn't make sense.
What's more disappointing? Because you said a lot and you moved my heart a lot when you said it. Is it the aspect of he is a father himself?
Yeah.
Is it his responsibility to his team, or is it the obligation of him being a role model and having 13-year-old kids like your own son looking up to him? What moves your heart the most when you think of the disappointment personally for you?
Right. So for me being a father, I'm a father and a mentor. I'm a godfather. So when my children and young adults, whatever, they look at me, they expect me to do certain things. And then I set a certain standard. Kobe Bryant set a standard when he was with the Lakers. Yeah, he might have been a little bit rough, but Michael Jordan set a standard. LeBron James sets a standard. It's a certain thing it's a responsibility that you have. So me as a father, because he's a father, and he's a mentor to kids, the team part it'll come together. Because if your structure at home and your structure within is solid, that everything else will be easier. But it's not solid. And that's what bothers me the most. It's not about the basketball. Now, if you take control of your person, your brand, mm-hmm. everything else will be in the place. All the other guys on the team, the Dylan Brookses of the world, right? All the other guys on the team, they think that's okay.
Yeah.
They think it's okay.
This is fascinating. This is interesting. I'm glad y'all are here to be a part of this conversation. Joy, I know you had some response, and it was an interesting response. Mm-hmm. What was your reaction after this latest suspension?
I mean, it probably won't be the most popular opinion, but he is an adult man. He is aware of the consequences of behaving like this because he just experienced the consequences of behaving like this.
Yep.
It has cost him a lot of money. It has cost his teammates. It has cost the organization. It has put the NBA in a bad position. And he obviously does not care.
He don't give a damn.
You can only plead ignorance for a certain amount of time.
Yeah.
You can only lean into the grace of excuses or youth or inexperience or bad influences for a certain amount of time. And then it becomes very obvious, at least to me, that I can't care more about your future and your finances and your legacy and your career than you do. I think if people are going through something and it is obvious that there is help needed, that there is intervention needed, and perhaps this is the case, I don't know, but it seems very obvious he is aware. He has spoken about it. He has done interviews. There has been suspensions. He is aware that doing something like this will have very serious consequences, and he continues to do it. So at what point does all of our pontificating about his behavior cease to matter? Because he has to make this decision for himself. It's why I try very hard not to refer to young people who are adults as kids. Because I can see myself at 23 and I was a disaster, and I will still continue to make mistakes throughout my life. But to Coutinho's point, I have a responsibility now that I didn't have when I was 23. Perhaps if I had had the responsibility that I have now at 23, I might have moved differently. Mm-hmm. I would have hoped if I was making those decisions with that responsibility that people would have sat me down and told me very seriously what the consequences would be. So that's one half of why I feel like this is in Ja Morant's hands now. His future is in his hands. Everyone has warned him. I'm sure people have reached out to him. I'm sure mentors have spoken to him, have spoken to his family. He's spoken to the commissioner. He's spoken to the NBA. I'm sure he's spoken to all of his corporate sponsors. I'm sure other people have reached out to him. And he is still choosing to behave this way. So at some point, it's in Ja Morant's hands, and that's how I feel. The other side of this to me is we have a state religion in this country, and it is gun violence.
Man, listen. Listen. Y'all, this is freaking despicable. In my opinion, it's not about no more, oh, you know, he just, you know, leave a black man alone and he, you know, he's just a victim. No. No. This is on purpose. This is him just point blank not giving a damn about what society say, about what kids say, about what the NBA say. He don't give a damn. That's just what this is. And so I think the team needs to make a real, real, honest, just listen, he ain't playing anyway. You're not going to win no games with him right now anyway. Fire him. Get rid of him. Give him like a year suspension to something crazy to let him get himself together. What's up, Jeff Short? Yeah, the man is crazy. Ja Morant messed up again, showing gun videos again. Unbelievable. Right? No, they didn't cut the video. I turned it off. I ain't want to play the whole video. Shout out to Speak. What is this? Speak May is Live, whoever that is. Yeah, shout out to them. Fox Sports, shout out to Fox Sports. Y'all go check out that interview. No. The video, did they cut it off? Oh shit, they did. Right, Matt, your stream was interrupted. Y'all hold on. All right, I'm back. Am I back on here? Hold on, y'all. Let me see. Okay, okay, cool. We back. Okay. Yeah. Fox Sports. I tried, gave him a shout out. Damn. All right, that wasn't good enough. Okay, so y'all, last thing. Let's talk about Debo. Okay. For those of y'all that's been following me, I don't got no, there were some things that Debo did to some people that I care about a lot. Talked about, you know, sodomizing Larry's wife and his kids, his daughter. That right there is despicable. In my opinion, it's unforgivable, and it's simply horrible, right? You know, talked about walking over Levi Mama grave and despicable stuff, right? I know that, and I don't condone any of that kind of stuff. And, you know, karma does have its way of coming back around on people. And I think that this situation right here is a form of karma. But, you know, the man searched for one of the jurors on his, I believe he's had a driving violation charge, and he searched for one of the jurors and found her, text her about something. I didn't want your white ass on my jury, bitch. That was what he said to her. The lady went down, filed charges where he's from. They came, locked him up, and he is still, last I checked, locked up, right? We got to do better, y'all. We got to do better. He already beat the feds. You know, he had that one charge, you know, he's under a, what do you call that thing? Some type of agreement that he had with them where the case should be getting dismissed. I don't know how this is going to, I believe that they charged him with a felony in this situation. So it's not looking good. I don't know what's going to happen with him. You know, pray for the man's kids. But I think that when you make decisions like this, you're not thinking about your family. You know, I've had videos on here that, you know, defend Debo, that speak up for him, but you can't defend nothing like this. You can't defend nothing like this. Like, you know, it's a lot of commentators out there that have talked about it that have been able to break this down on a much deeper level. My thing is, because you can't, karma's not going to come back to you in a good way when you put out so many negative things. It's going to come back around the way it come back around. And so, you know, like I said, I want to just, you know, give his kids, you know, a blessing, you know, but as far as what he got to go through, you know, that man made that decision for himself. I don't know what's going to happen. It's not my call, but, definitely not the right move, Debo. Not the right move at all, man. So, you know, it's going to be what it's going to be. What up, Keller? What up, bro? What's going on? Howard Janelle, wow, that's crazy. Talking about somebody's mom's grave. Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, that was on a different level. That was on a different level. You know, talking about, you know, the stuff with Larry's wife and all this, and it's just insane, right? So that situation is that situation. This is my first time speaking on it. Sometimes I'll let stuff be, and then I'll come back and speak on it when I'm ready to speak on it. I've learned to not talk out of emotion, because a lot of times when you come on with emotion, you say a lot of things you really don't mean, and then you go back and say, oh, well, you know, I really didn't mean that. Mm-mm. Everything I'm talking about right now, that's how I feel. I stand on it. Okay? But listen, y'all, we have to make sure that when we see things, or there's things that really bother you spiritually, mentally, and emotionally, you know, those things like really do affect people's lives. Like a lot of this stuff that's happening on YouTube, it transfers into people's real life, bringing people's blood pressures up, right? People stressed out, people arguing, fussing, fighting, all this kind of stuff, right? So we have to, sometimes it's good to just turn the doggone internet off. Just turn it off. Don't watch it, right? But listen, man, I didn't plan on getting on here a long time. I appreciate y'all hopping in here. If you didn't get to see the full video, rewind it to the beginning, and you'll be able to see what we're talking about. On your way out, if y'all don't mind hitting that like button for me, I got 38 in, 24 likes. Tune! Tune the Goon, what's up, bro? Tune just had a birthday, y'all, man. Tune just had his 55th birthday. Shout out to Tune. Happy birthday, bro. Looked like you had a good birthday, man. I saw that cologne. I think you got some good smelling stuff over there. But listen, y'all, I want y'all to know that I love y'all. Thank y'all very much for coming over here. And I'll holler at y'all later, man. Peace out.